Dear students, myself Mallikarjun Zarathy. In this video, I am going to solve one more important NEET exam model question paper which helps to your NEET exam. As 46th question, see here. Dissolving 120 gram of a compound of molecular weight 60 in 1000 gram of water gave a solution of density 1.12 gram per ml. The molarity of the solution is, see the question once again, dissolving 120 gram of a compound of molecular weight 60 in 1000 gram of water gave a solution of density 1.12 gram per ml. The molarity of the solution is option A 1.00 m, option B 2.00 m, option C 2.50 m, and option D 4.00 m. Yes. See, the given data according to the question is mass of the solute is W equal to 120 gram, mass of the solvent 1000 gram, molecular mass of the solute equal to 60 gram, density of the solution is 1.12 gram per ml. This given data, or from the given data, mass of the solution means total mass of the solution equal to 1000 plus 120 equal to 1120 gram. Then we know formula T equal to mass divided by volume, or volume equal to molar mass divided by D. Volume of solution V equal to molecular mass, it is 1120, we already calculated, divided by 1.12, means density is given 1.12 equal to 1000 ml or 1 liter. Therefore, now molarity equal to W divided by molecular mass into volume is equal to 120 divided by 60 into 1, we get the answer 2 m. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option B, 2.00 m. 2.00 m is the answer. Next, question number 47. The standard enthalpy of formation delta H F H0 is 298. For methane, CH4 is minus 74.9 kilojoule per mole. In order to calculate the average energy given out in the formation of carbon hydrogen bond from this, it is necessary to know which one of the following. See the question once again. The standard enthalpy of formation for methane, CH4, is minus 74.9 kilojoule per mole. In order to calculate the average energy given out in the formation of carbon hydrogen bond from this, it is necessary to know which one of the following. Option A, dissociation energy of the hydrogen molecule H2. Option B, the first four ionization energies of the carbon. Option C, the dissociation energy of H2 and enthalpy of sublimation of carbon, means graphite. Option D, the first four ionization energies of the carbon and electron affinity of hydrogen. Yes. See the options given for this question carefully. Finally, we conclude and we know the concept. to calculate the average enthalpy of carbon hydrogen bond in methane, following informations are needed. What are those information? See here. One is dissociation energy of hydrogen molecule is 1 by 2 H2 gives hydrogen gas. And another one, sublimation energy of carbon, presence of graphite to carbon. This is given in reaction type. C graphite gives C gas, where delta H equal to Y. Then C of graphite means carbon, presence of graphite plus 2H2 gave CH4, methane formation, delta H equal to 75 kilojoule per mole. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is the dissociation energy of H2 and enthalpy of sublimation of carbon. Option C is right answer. Next, question number 48. Question number 48. 1.08 gram of pure silver was converted into silver nitrate and its solution was taken in a beaker. It was electrolyzed using platinum cathode and silver anode. 0.01 Faradays of electricity was passed using 0.15 volt above the decomposition potential of silver. The silver content of the beaker after the above shall be. Let's see the question once again. 1.08 gram of pure silver was converted into silver nitrate and its solution was taken in a beaker. It was electrolyzed using platinum cathode and silver anode. 0.01 Faraday of electricity was passed using 0.15 volt above the decomposition potential of silver. The silver content of the beaker after the above shall be. Option A, 0 gram. Option B, 0.108 gram. Option C, 0.108 gram. Option D, 1.08 gram. Yes. Answer for this question. For answer for this question, see here. We know silver ion by addition of an electron means in presence of one Faraday, it gives AgO or converted into silver Ag. Then we know 1 Faraday is equal to 1 mole of electrons, nothing but 96,500 coulombs. 0.01 Faraday is equal to 1.08 gram Ag, where Ag left equal to 1.08 minus 1.08 is equal to 0. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option A, 0 gram is the right answer. Next, question number 49. Number of electrons transferred in each case. Number of electrons transferred in each case when K-menophore act as an oxidizing agent to give MnO2, Mn2 plus MnOH twice and MnO4 2 minus R respectively. Option A, 3, 5, 4 and 1. Option B, 4, 3, 1 and 5. Option C, 1, 3, 4 and 5. Option D, 5, 4, 3 and 1. Yes. See this column. Observe the column carefully. Here I given the given components like MnO4, sorry, KMnO4, MnO2, Mn2 plus, MnOH twice, MnO4, O minus. Oxidation state of Mn in a particular components and electrons needed here. Yes, in presence of KMnO4, Mn oxidation state is plus 7. In presence of MnO2, it is plus 4. Mn2 plus is plus 2, MnOH twice in that Mn oxidation state is plus 3, and MnO4 2 minus is plus 6. Electrons needed 0, 3, 5, 4 and 1 respectively. Therefore, according to the question, number of electrons transferred in each case when KMnO4 act as an oxidizing agent to give the particular components is 3, 5, 4 and 1. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option A. 3, 5, 4 and 1 is the right answer. Next question number 50. Addition of HI to double bond of propene yields isopropyl iodide and not N-propyl iodide as the major product because of addition proceeds through. See the question once again. Addition of hydrogen iodide to double bond of propene yields isopropyl iodide but not N-propyl iodide as the major product because addition proceeds through. Option A, a more stable carbonium ion. Option B, a more stable carbanion. Option C, a more stable free radical. Option D, homolysis. Yes, see this question carefully and observe the options given for this question. All are examples for electrophilic addition reactions. All are examples for electrophilic addition reactions and involve the formation of stable carbocation. Remember, students, all are examples for electrophilic addition reactions and involve the formation of stable carbocation leading to the formation of addition product according to Markovnikov's rule. What is Markovnikov's rule? When asymmetrical molecule is added to the asymmetrical alkene, the negative part of the added molecule goes and attack the carbon atom which contains least number of hydrogen atoms. Therefore, if we know this concept, the answer for this question is option A. It contains a more stable carbonium ion. Option A is the right answer. Next question number 51. Which of the following is a biodegradable polymer? Which of the following is a biodegradable polymer? What are biodegradable polymers? Remember, these are the polymers which are degraded by the microorganisms. Polymers which are degraded by the microorganisms are called as biodegradable polymers. PHPV, nylon 2, nylon 6. These are some examples for biodegradable polymers. Yes, observe the given options. Among these, which of the following is a biodegradable polymer? See the given options carefully. Students, answer for this. First, you see the polymer formation reaction. Here, number of NH2, CH2COOH plus of NH2CH25COOH. It gives the product NH CH2 5 C double bond O NH CH2 C double bond O with respect to number of N terms. The polymer is nylon 2, nylon 6. It is one of the biodegradable step growth copolymer. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option A itself. It is the structure of nylon 2, nylon 6. Yes, next question number 52. Which of the following is a redox reaction? What are redox reactions? Reactions which involves both oxidation and reduction simultaneously. The reaction which involves both oxidation and reduction simultaneously are called as redox reactions. See the options given here. The reaction of H2SO4 with NaOH. Option B, in atmosphere O3 from O2 by lightening process. Option C, nitrogen oxides from nitrogen and oxygen decomposition by lightening. Option D, evaporation of water. Reaction of H2SO4 with NaOH in atmosphere O3 from O2 by lightening. Nitrogen oxides from nitrogen and oxygen decomposition by lightening. Evaporation of water. Students, among the given options, a particular reactions, see here, N2 plus O2 gives 2 moles of NO, means nitric oxide. In this reaction, oxidation of nitrogen is changes from 0 to plus 2, because N2 here, this is 0 in molecular form, but in presence of nitric oxide, NO, the oxidation state of nitrogen is plus 2. Therefore, in particular this reaction, oxidation number of nitrogen is changed from 0 to plus 12. Therefore, oxidation takes place. And oxidation number of oxygen, it changes from 0 to minus 2, reduction takes place. O2 means molecular form, it is 0, but in presence of NO, this is minus 2, their production takes place. Means nitrogen oxides from nitrogen and oxygen decomposition by lightening, this process involves both oxidation and reduction, then definitely it is one example for the redox reaction. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option C. Option C is the right answer. Next question number 53. Standard entropy of X2, Y2 and XY3 are 60, 40 and 50 joule per Kelvin per mole respectively for the reaction. Half X2 plus 3 by 2 of Y2 gives XY3, where delta H equal to minus 30 kilojoule to be at equilibrium. The temperature will be, see the question once again carefully. Standard entropy of X2, Y2 and XY3 are 60, 40 and 50 joule per Kelvin per mole respectively. For the reaction, 1 by 2 X2 plus 3 by 2 Y2 gives XY3, where delta H equal to minus 30 kilojoule to be at equilibrium. The temperature will be, option A, 1250 Kelvin, option B, 500 Kelvin, option C, 1000 Kelvin, option D, 750 Kelvin. Students, for a reaction to be equilibrium, we know, for a reaction to be equilibrium, delta G equal to 0. Since, see here, delta G equal to delta H minus T delta S, so at equilibrium, where delta H minus T delta S equal to 0 or delta H equal to T delta S. For the reaction, half X2 plus 3 by 2 Y2 gives XY3. Calculating the delta S change in entropy, for the above reaction, we get delta S equal to 50 minus of 1 by 2 into 60 plus of 3 by 2 into 40 joule per Kelvin. For simplification, 50 minus of 30 plus 60 joule per Kelvin are all equal to minus 40 joule per Kelvin. At equilibrium, we know T delta S equal to delta H. We already calculated delta S value. Substitute that value, T into minus 40 equal to minus 30 into 1000, 1 kilojoule. because 1 kilojoule equal to 1000 joules. Therefore, finally we get T equal to minus 30 into 1000 divided by minus 40. We get the value 750 Kelvin. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option D. Option D is the right answer. 750 Kelvin temperature is the right answer. Next question number 54. The cell constant of a given cell is 0.47 per centimeter. The cell constant of a given cell is 0.47 per centimeter. The resistance of a solution placed in this cell is measured to be 31.6 ohm. The conductivity of the solution in Simon per centimeter, where S has usual meaning, is. The cell constant of a given cell is 0.47 per centimeter. The resistance of a solution placed in this cell is measured to be 31.6 ohm. The conductivity of the solution is option A 0.15, option B 1.5, option C 0.015, option D 150. Yes, we know the formula. Students, we know the formula K equal to 1 by R into cell constant, where R is gas constant. When we get, substitute the value, then we get 0.47 divided by 31.6 is equal to 0.01487, but near answer is 0.015. therefore option C is the right answer. This one of the simple answer if you know the formula. The correct answer for 54th question is C, 0.015. Next question number 55. Consider the following changes. Consider the following changes. What are the changes? See here. A, it changes to A plus, loss of one electron. E1 and A plus changes to A2 plus, plus of E minus E2. The energy required to pull out the two electrons are E1 and E2 respectively. The correct relationship between two energies would be option A, E1 is less than E2, option B, E1 equal to E2, option C, E1 is greater than E2, option D, E1 is greater than or equal to E2. Yes, students, we know ionization energy of first electron is less than ionization energy of second electron. Please remember this concept. This is one of the direct question. Ionization energies of first electron is less than ionization energy of second electron. What is ionization energy? It is the amount of energy required to remove an outermost electron of an gaseous atom. Therefore, E1 is less than E2, means option A is the right answer. You remember this concept. Ionization energy of first electron is less than ionization energy of second electron. Next, question number 56. The major organic compound formed by the reaction of 111 trichloroethane with silver powder is. The major organic compound formed by the reaction of 111 trichloroethane with silver powder is option A, acetylene, option B, ethene, option C, 2-butyne, option D, 2-butene. See the question once again. The major organic compound formed by the reaction of 111 trichloroethane with silver powder is. Yes, answer for this question, you must know the reaction takes place in presence of reactants as well as product side. Therefore, see here, 111 trichloroethane and it is treated with silver 96 moles of Az, we get the product like this, CH3C triple bond C of CH3 means 2 butane is the product with the formation of 6 moles of silver chloride. Yes, which one is the answer now? Option C, 2 butane is the correct answer for this question. The major organic compound formed by the reaction of 111 trichloroethane with silver powder is 2 butane. Option C is the right answer. Yes, question number 57. The end product C in the following sequence of the reaction is, one of the reaction is given here, see carefully, ethyne in presence of 1% mercury sulfate, 20% of sulfuric acid, and we get the product A, and that product A is treated with naphthalene reagent CH3MgX. In presence of water, the product B is formed. When it undergoes oxidation, the product C is formed. What is that C product? The end product C in the following sequence of the reaction is, option A, acetic acid, option B, isopropyl alcohol, option C, acetone, option D, ethanol. Yes, first you see the complete reaction involved in the reaction is, first when ethyne is reaction takes place in presence of mercury sulfate and sulfuric acid, we get CH3CHO means ethanol dehyde. In presence of CH3MgX means Grignard reagent, we get the product CH3CHOHCH3, and when it undergoes oxidation, we get the product acetone, nothing but CH3COCH3. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option C, acetone is the right answer. Please remember the complete reactions which involved in a particular reaction, particular question. Therefore, option C, acetone is the right answer. Next question number 58. At 0 degree Celsius and 1 atmospheric pressure, at 0 degree Celsius and 1 atmospheric pressure, a gas occupies 100 cc. If the pressure is increased to 1.5 time and temperature is increased by 1/3 of absolute temperature, then the final volume of the gas will be. See question once again. At 0 degree Celsius and 1 atmospheric pressure, a gas occupies 100 cc. If the pressure is increased to 1.5 time and temperature is increased by 1/3 of absolute temperature, then final volume of the gas will be. Option A, 80 cc. Option B, 88.9 cc. Option C, 66.7 cc. Option D, 100 cc. Yes. Apply the formula P1 V1 upon T1 equal to P2 V2 upon T2. Yes. Calculation part. Initial temperature P1 is equal to 0 degree. Means 273 Kelvin. Initial pressure is given 1 atmospheric pressure. Initial volume is 100 cc. Final temperature is T2 equal to 1 plus 1 by 3 to 273.15. It becomes equal to 364.2 Kelvin. Final pressure P2 equal to 1/2 into 1 is equal to 1.5 atmospheric pressure. Then we want to calculate the final volume P2 equal to question mark. Yes, we know the formula P1 V1 upon T1 equal to P2 V2 upon T2. Substitute the values, 1 atmospheric pressure into 100 cc divided by T1 273.15 Kelvin is equal to 1.5 atmospheric pressure into V2 divided by 364.2 Kelvin. after calculating, finally we get the value, means V2 equal to 88.9 is the answer. 88.9 cc is the value. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option B, 88.9 cc is the answer. 58th question answer is option B, 88.9 cc. Next question number 59. Which one of the following statement is not true? Remember, which one of the given following statements is not true? Option A, the conjugate base of H2PO4 minus is HPO42 minus. Option B, pH plus POH equal to 14 for all aqueous solutions. Option C, the pH of 1 into 10 to the power of minus 8 mHCl is 8. Option D, 96,500 coulombs of electricity when passed through a copper sulfate solution deposits 1 gram equivalent of copper at the cathode. See the given options carefully, because the question is which one of among the following statement is not true. Students, when we observe the given options carefully, the pH of 1 into 10 to the power of minus 8 mHCl is always less than 7. Remember, the pH of 1 into 10 to the power of minus 8 mHCl is always less than 7, since the solution is on of the acid. It can be shown as H plus equal to, means concentration of hydrogen ion, is equal to 10 to the power of minus 7 from H2O and 10 to the power of minus 8 from HCl, where concentration of H plus equal to 10 to the power of minus 8 into 10 plus 1 is equal to concentration of H plus equal to 10 to the power of minus 8 into 11, where minus log of H plus equal to 8 log 10 minus log 11, where pH equal to 8 minus log 11, pH equal to 6.93. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option C. This one is the wrong statement. This is not true statement. Next question number 60. For a reaction of a type A plus B gives products. A plus B gives products. It is observed that doubling concentration of A causes the reaction rate to be 4 times as great, but the doubling amount of B does not affect the rate. The rate equation is, see question carefully once again. For a reaction of a type A plus B gives products, it is observed that doubling concentration of A causes the reaction rate to be 4 times as great, but doubling amount of B does not affect the rate. The rate equation is, option A, rate equal to K into the concentration of A into concentration of B. Option B, rate equal to K divided by 4 concentration of A to the power 2. Option C, rate equal to K into concentration of A to the power 2 B to the power 0. Option D, rate equal to K into concentration of A square and concentration of B to the square. Students, according to the question, rate law of equation B, R equal to K to concentration of A to the power X B to the power Y, is taken as equation 1. When A equal to 2A, then the reaction becomes 4R equal to K, 2A to the concentration of 2A to the power of X and concentration of B to the power Y. Divide equation 2 by 1, then 4R divided by R equal to K, concentration of 2A to the power of X, concentration of B to the power Y, divided by K, concentration of A to the power X, B to the power Y. Therefore, get 4 equal to 2 to the power of X, hence X equal to 2, B equal to 2B. and R equal to K A to the power X concentration of 2B to the power Y. Make it this equation 3. Therefore, 1 equal to divide 3 by 1. R by R equal to K to the concentration of A to the power X concentration of 2B to the power Y divided by A concentration of A to the power X concentration of B to the power Y into 2 to the power of Y. Therefore, Y equal to 0. The rate is equal to K A to the power 2 B to the power 0. Yes, this is the solution steps. If you know this, then the correct answer for this question is option C, where rate equal to K A to the power 2 B to the power 0. Option C is the right answer. Next question number 61. The electronegativity follows the order. The electronegativity follows the order. Option A, fluorine is greater than oxygen, greater than chlorine, greater than bromine. Option B, fluorine is greater than chlorine, greater than bromine, greater than oxygen. Option C, oxygen is greater than fluorine, greater than chlorine, greater than bromine. Option D, chlorine is greater than fluorine, greater than oxygen, greater than bromine. Yes, students, we know fluorine and oxygen belongs to second period, whereas chlorine and bromine belongs to third and fourth periods respectively. Remember, fluorine and oxygen belongs to second period, whereas chlorine and bromine belongs to third and fourth periods respectively. Hence, the sequence of the electronegativity is fluorine is greater than oxygen, greater than chlorine, greater than bromine. Electronegativity increases across the period from left to right and decreases down the group from top to bottom. Therefore, electronegativity is inversely proportional to the radius or radii. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option A. Fluorine is greater than oxygen, is greater than chlorine, is greater than bromine is the right answer. Next question number 62. Which of the following is not formed when glycerol reacts with hydroiodic acid or hydrogen iodide? See the question once again. Which of the following is not formed when glycerol reacts with HI? Option A, which one of the following is not formed when glycerol reacts with HI? Option A, CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2I. Option B, CH2OH, single bond CHI, single bond CH2OH. Option C, CS3CH, double bond CH2. Option D, CS3CHI, CS3. Glycerol reacts with HI in two ways. First, you remember, glycerol reacts with HI in two ways. In that first one, when glycerol is warmed in small amount of hydrogen iodide, allyl iodide is formed. And another one, when glycerol is heated with excess of HI, the allyl iodide formed first is reduced to propene. Propene in presence of excess of HI forms isopropyl iodide. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option B. Option B is the right answer. Next question number 63. The amine that does not react with acetyl chloride is? The amine that does not react with acetyl chloride is option A CS3NH2, option B CS3 twice NH, option C CS3 twice N, option D none of these. This is the question. The amine that does not react with acetyl chloride is. Students, the compounds containing active hydrogen atoms, means hydrogen atoms attached to nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur. Remember, the compounds containing active hydrogen atoms reacts with CH3COCl, acetyl chloride, to form acetyl derivatives. To form acetyl derivatives. Tertiary amine cannot be acetylated because of replaceable hydrogen atoms. Here, replaceable hydrogen atoms is absent. Therefore, the correct answer for this question, option C. The compounds containing active hydrogen atoms react with acetyl chloride to form acetyl derivative. Active hydrogen atoms means they attach to nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur. Yes, therefore, option C is the right answer. Next question number 64. The plot shows the variation of minus ln Kp versus temperature for two reactions. What are those two reactions? See here, M plus half O2 gas gives MO and carbon plus half O2 gives carbon monoxide. Identify the correct statement. Option A, at T is less than 1200 Kelvin, oxidation of carbon is unfavorable. Option B, oxidation of carbon is favorable at all temperatures. Option C, at temperature less than 1200 Kelvin, the reaction MO plus C of solid gives M plus carbon monoxide is spontaneous. Option D, at temperature is greater than 1200 Kelvin, carbon will reduce MO to M. See the graph carefully. Here carbon gives carbon monoxide, M gives MO. Ln Kp versus temperature is present in the given diagram. Yes, students, first you see the graph which is given already. Here, at temperature less than 1200 Kelvin, carbon will reduce MO to M. Hence, chemical reaction MO solid plus C of solid gives M of solid plus carbon monoxide gas is one of the spontaneous. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option C. Option C is the right answer. Next question number 65. For preparing a buffer solution of pH 6 by mixing sodium acetate and acetic acid, the ratio of the concentration of salt and acid should be. See the question once again. For preparing a buffer solution of pH 6 by mixing sodium acetate and acetic acid, the ratio of the concentration of salt and acid should be, where A equal to 10 to the power of minus 5. Option A, 1 is to 10. Option B, 10 is to 1. Option C, 100 is to 1. And option D, 1 is to 100. This is the question. For preparing a buffer solution of pH 6 by mixing sodium acetate and acetic acid, the ratio of the concentration of salt and acid should be. Yes, for answer, first you see here 6 equal to minus log of 10 to the power of minus 5 plus log salt by acid is equal to 5U plus log of salt divided by acid. Log of salt by acid must be 1. Therefore, salt by acid is equal to 10 divided by 1, means 10 is to 1 is the answer. Therefore, option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Next question number 66. The activation energy for a hypothetical reaction. The activation energy for a hypothetical reaction A gives product is 12.49 Kelvin calorie per mole. If temperature is raised from 295 to 305, the rate of the reaction increased by. See the question once again. The activation energy for a hypothetical reaction A gives product is 12.49 Kelvin calorie per mole. If the temperature is raised from 295 to 305, the rate of the reaction increased by option A 60%, option B 100%, option C 50%, option D 20%. Students, we know one concept. For 10 degrees Celsius rise of temperature, the rate becomes almost double. Remember, for 10 degrees Celsius rise of temperature, the rate of reaction, it becomes almost double. If you know this concept, then the correct answer for this question is option B, 100% is the right answer. Next, question number 67. Boron trichloride is a planar molecule, whereas nitrogen trichloride is pyramidal because. BCl3 is planar molecule, whereas NCl3 is pyramidal because. Option A, BCl3 has no lone pair of electrons, but NCl3 has a lone pair of electrons. Option B, BCl bond is more polar than NCl bond. Option C, nitrogen atom is smaller than boron atom. Option D, NCl bond is more covalent than BCl bond. Students, when you observe the given options, remember the concept. In the BCl3, there is a sp2 hybridization, means planar, but in NCl3 hybridization is sp3, hence shape is pyramidal. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is BCl3 has no lone pair of electrons, but NCl3 has a lone pair of electrons. These are responsible for the particular type of structure. Therefore, correct answer is option A. Answer A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. Next, question number 68. Indicate the wrongly named compound. First one, 4-methyl-1-pentanol is given. 2-methyl-1-pentanoic acid is given. Second option, C. And B option is 4-methyl-2-pentyne-1-oic acid. Option 3, hexene 5-ohm. Clearly observe the particular compound with respect to its name, because the question is which one is wrongly matched with a particular structure with name. Yes, students, when we observe all the given four options with respect to structures, I think option D is one of the wrong naming system, because they given 3-hexene-5-ohm, but the correct name of this compound is, you can start the numbering from this side, carbon containing double bond O side, The correct name is hex 3 in 5 on. Hex 3 in 5 on is the right answer. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option B. Next question number 69. An organic compound C3H6O does not give a precipitate with 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine reagent and does not react with metallic sodium. It could be. See the question once again carefully. An organic compound C3H6O does not give a precipitate with 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine. It's one of the reagent and does not react with metallic sodium. It could be. Clearly observe the given four options. Students, remember this concept. Negative reaction with 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine indicates absence of aldehydic group. In presence of option A, negative reaction with 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine indicates the absence of aldehyde group and ketonic group also. While negative reaction with metallic sodium indicates the absence of an alcoholic group. According to option B, the negative reaction with metallic sodium indicates the absence of an alcoholic group. Option B. Hence, the organic compound is C3H6O is CH2 double bond CHO CS3 option D. Therefore, option D is the right answer. Option D is the correct answer for given question. Next question number 70. Which one of the following pairs of molecules will have permanent dipole moments for both members? Which one of the following pairs of molecules will have permanent dipole moments for both members? Option A, SiF4 and NO2. Option B, NO2 and CO2. Option C, NO2 and O3. Option D, SiF4 and CO2. This is the question. See carefully, which one of the following pairs of molecules will have permanent dipole moment for both members? Yes, when we observe the given options, SiF4 and CO2, SiF4 and CO2 have zero dipole moment due to symmetrical tetrahedral and linear structures. NO2 and O3 both have V shape and certain value for dipole moment. If you know this concept, the correct answer for this question is option C. Option C is the right answer. NO2 and O3 is the right answer because NO2 and O3 both have V shape and certain value for dipole moment. Next question number 71. An element has BCC structure, body center cubic structure, having unit cells 12.08 × 10³. The number of atoms in these cells is option A, 12.08 × 10³. Option B, 24.16 × 10³. Option C, 48.38 × 10³. Option D, 12.08 × 10². See the question once again. An element has BCC structure having unit cells 12.08 × 10². The number of atoms in these cells is option A, 12.08 × 10². Option B, 24.16 × 10². Option C, 48.38 × 10². Option D, 12.08 × 10². Yes, answer for this question, please see here. number of unit cells is equal to total number of molecules divided by rank of unit cell or Z. Number of atoms is equal to the given value 12.08 into 10 to the power of 23 into 2. Therefore, it is equal to 24.16 into 10 to the power of 23. For BCC, we know number of atoms Z equal to 2. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option B. 24.16 into 10 to the power of 23 is the right answer. Option B is the correct answer for 71 question. Next question number 72. An unknown metal M displaces nickel from nickel to sulfate solution but does not displace manganese from manganese sulfate solution. Which order represents the correct order of reducing power? An unknown metal M displaces nickel from nickel to sulfate solution but does not displace manganese from manganese sulfate solution. Which order represents the correct order of reducing power? Option A, manganese is greater than nickel, greater than metal. Option B, nickel is greater than manganese, greater than metal. Option C, manganese greater than metal, greater than nickel. Option D, metal is greater than nickel, greater than manganese. Students, oxidation potential of M is more than nickel. Remember, oxidation potential of metal is more than nickel and less than manganese. Hence, reducing power is Mn is greater than M greater than nickel. Is manganese greater than metal greater than nickel is the correct answer, where it is given in the option C, it is present. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option C, Mn is greater than metal greater than nickel. Option C is the right answer. Next question number 73. From the following statements regarding H2O2, choose the incorrect statement. From the following statement regarding hydrogen peroxide, choose the incorrect statement. Option A, it has to be stored in plastic or wax lined glass bottles in a dark. Option B, it has to be kept away from dust. Option C, it can act only as an oxidizing agent. And option D, it decomposes on exposed to light. Question is, from the following statements regarding hydrogen peroxide, choose the incorrect statement. In students, when you observe the given options which are related to the hydrogen peroxide, in that option C, they given only, it can act only as an oxidizing agent. No. This hydrogen peroxide is one of the reagents which has oxidizing and reducing properties both. Therefore, the correct answer means according to the question, the incorrect statement related to the hydrogen peroxide is option C. Because why this one is the wrong statement? They given only oxidizing agent. Hydrogen peroxide is only one of the oxidizing agents. No, because hydrogen peroxide, it can act both oxidizing as well as reducing agent. Next question number 74. Bernstein test is given by which of the following? Bernstein test is given by which of the following? Option A, halogens. Option B, thiourea. Option C, pyridine. Option D, all. Yes. Students, pyridine and thiourea form volatile cupric cyanide and also give bluish green flame like volatile cupric halides. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option D, all of the following. Bernstein test given by which of the following? Or halogen, thiourea, pyridine, etc. Therefore, all is the right answer. Next question number 75. Complete hydrolysis of starch gives. This is one of the theoretical questions. Complete hydrolysis of starch gives option A glucose only, option B galactose and fructose in equimolar amounts, option C glucose and galactose in equimolar amounts, option D glucose and fructose in equimolar amounts. This is the question. Complete hydrolysis of starch gives. Yes, this question is based on biomolecule chapter. Starch is a mixture of amylose and amylopectin, polysaccharides, and monomer is glucose. Thus, on complete hydrolysis, it gives only glucose. Starch undergo hydrolysis, it forms glucose in its. Therefore, option A, glucose only, is the right answer. Yes, question number 76. At standard temperature and pressure, the order of root mean square speed of molecules. Root mean square speed of molecules. H2, N2, O2 and HBRAs. At STP, the order of root mean square speed of molecules. H2, N2, O2 and HBRAs. Option A, H2 is greater than N2, greater than O2, greater than HBR. Option B, HBR is greater than O2, greater than N2, greater than H2. Option C, HBR is greater than H2, greater than O2, greater than N2. Option D, N2 is greater than O2, greater than H2, greater than HBR. Yes, we know formula. Students, see here, we know the formula. Mu RMS is proportional to the root of 1 by m at STP. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option A. Remember, H2 is greater than N2, greater than O2, greater than HBR. Yes, question number 77. Which of the following is not true? Among the following, which of the following is not true? Option A, some disinfectants can be used as antiseptics. Option B, sulfadiazine is a synthetic antibacterial. Option C, aspirin is analgesic as well as antipyretic. Option D, polystyrene is used to make non-stick cookware. Yes, which of the following is not true? When you observe the given options, among this, option A, B, C are right statements, but observe the D option. Polystyrene is used to make non-stick cookware. Polystyrene is used for making non-stick cookware, but the polystyrene is not used for non-stick cookware. Therefore, option D is right answer, because among these options, it is one of the not true statement. Next question number 78. A solution is prepared by mixing 8.5 gram of CH2Cl2 and 11.95 gram of CHCl3. If vapor pressure of CH2Cl2 and CHCl3 at 298 Kelvin are 415 and 200 mmHg respectively, the mole fraction of CHCl3 in vapor form is. See the question once again. A solution is prepared by mixing 8.5 gram of CH2Cl2 and 11.9 gram of CHCl3. If vapor pressure of CH2Cl2 and CHCl3 at 298 Kelvin are 415 and 200 mmHg respectively, mole fraction of CHCl3 in vapor form is. The molecular mass of Cl is given, that is 35.5 gram per mole. Option A, 0.162, option B, 0.675, ऑप्शन सी 0.325, ऑप्शन डी 0.486। यस, गो थ्रू द सॉल्यूशन पार्ट। सी हियर, मोलार मास ऑफ CaCl3 इज ऑलरेडी गिवन, इज 119 ग्राम पर मोल। मोलार मास ऑफ मोलार मास ऑफ CaCl3 इज 11.95 ग्राम। मोलार मास ऑफ CH2Cl2 इज 85 ग्राम पर मोल। मोल्स ऑफ CaCl3 इट इज 11.95 डिवाइडेड बाय 119.5 इक्वल टू 0.1 मोल। मोल्स ऑफ CH2Cl2 इक्वल टू 8.5 डिवाइडेड बाय 85 इक्वल टू 0.1 मोल। Then mole fraction must be calculated. Mole fraction of CHCl3 equal to 0.1 divided by 0.2 equal to 0.5 mole. Mole fraction of CH2Cl2 is 0.1 divided by 0.2. It is also 0.5 mole. The given options means given values: vapor pressure of CHCl3 equal to 200 mm. Mercury is equal to 0.263 atmosphere pressure. Vapor pressure of CH2Cl3 equal to 415 mm. Mercury is 0.546 atmosphere. 1 atmosphere pressure equal to, we know, 760 mmHg. Therefore, P, pressure above solution, is equal to mole fraction of CHCl3 into vapor pressure of CHCl3 plus mole fraction of CH2Cl2 into vapor pressure of CH2Cl2. Substitute all the values. There is 0.5 into 0.263 plus of 0.5 into 0.546 equal to 0.4045. Mole fraction of CHCl3 in vapor form is 0.1315 divided by 0.4045. Finally, we get the answer 0.325. Therefore, option C is the right answer. 0.325 is the right answer. Next question number 79. Match list 1 with list 2 and select the correct answer using the codes given below the list. In the list 1, they given first one cyanide process, second one flotation process, third one electrolytic reduction, option 4 means fourth one is Joule refining. In the list 2, they given A, ultra pure germanium, B, pine oil, C, extraction of aluminium, D, extraction of gold, and codes are given here. Match the correct appropriate choice. Observe the list 1 and list 2 contents carefully. Yes, students, cyanide process is used for gold. We know cyanide process is for gold, means for first option in the list one, that is D in the list 2. And flotation process is used for fine oil. In the flotation process, fine oil is used. Therefore, second point in list 1 is correct matched with the B option in the list 2. And electrolytic reduction, that is extraction of aluminium, means third option of list 1 is correctly matched with the C option of list 2. And Joule refining is related to the ultra pure germanium. Therefore, the fourth option in a list 1 is correctly matched with the A option in list 2. Yes, observe the course with respect to options where these are correctly matched. Yes, in the option B, they are correctly matched. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option B. Next question number 80. In which of the following resonance will be possible? Among the given options, in which of the following resonance will be possible? Option A, CH2, 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 CHO. Option B, CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH of double bond O. Option C, CS3, CO, CS3. Option D, CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2, single bond CH, double bond CH2. Students, when you observe the given structures in presence of respective options, in that observe the second point means structure B has a conjugated system, means they contain alternate single and double bond. In that process only the resonance is possible, because the conjugated system is necessary for resonance. The compounds containing alternate single and double bond shows resonance. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option B is the right answer. Next, question number 81. The radius of the second Bohr orbit for hydrogen atom is. The radius of the second Bohr orbit for hydrogen atom is. Planck's constant we know, they already given, H equal to 6.62 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules. Mass of electron is 9.109 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. Charge of electron E equal to 1.6021 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. Permittivity of vacuum E naught is equal to 8.85 into 10 to the power of minus 12 per kg per meter square. This option is 1.65 angstrom. Option B is 4.76 angstrom. Option C is 0.529 angstrom. Option A is 2.12 angstrom. Let's go to the solution steps one by one. Radius of nth Bohr orbit in hydrogen atom, we know it is 0.53 n square angstrom. Radius of second Bohr orbit equal to 0.53 into 2 to the power of 2. Finally, you get the answer 2.12 angstrom. Therefore, option D, 2.12 angstrom is the right answer. Next, question number 82. Point out the false statement. Point out the false statement. Among the given options, which one is the wrong statement? Option A. Brownian movement and Tyndall effects are shown by colloidal systems. Option B. Gold number is the measure of protective power of lyophilic colloid. Option C. The colloidal solution of a liquid in liquid is called gel. Option D. Hadley-Scholes rule is related with coagulation. Among the given options, which one is wrong statement here? Please carefully observe the given options. When you observe the given options, the option A, B and D are correct statements, because Hartree-Scholes rule is related to coagulation process. Gold number is major protective power of lyophilic colloid. Brownian moment and Tyndall effect are shown by colloidal systems. But the option C, the colloidal solution of a liquid in liquid is called gel. It is not a true statement, because liquid-liquid system is known as emulsion. Liquid-liquid system is an example for emulsion, but the given gel is not a right statement. Therefore, this one is the wrong statement. The correct answer for 82 question is option C. Next, question number 83. The compound A on heating gives a colorless gas and a residue which dissolve in water to give option the product of B. When excess of CO2 is passed into B and gently heated, A is formed. The compound A is. Please remember the, observe the question carefully. The compound A on heating, it gives a colorless gas and a residue which dissolves in water to give B. when excess of CO2 is passed into B and gently heated, A is formed, the compound A is. S option A is calcium sulfate, 2 moles of water. Option B is Na2CO3, option C is CaCO3, and option D, K2CO3. Yes. First, to observe the given reactions here, when calcium carbonate is heated, then we get calcium oxide plus CO2. And calcium oxide, when it is treated with water, then calcium hydroxide is formed, means the product B, it is nothing but calcium hydroxide. Then that calcium hydroxide is again treated with carbon dioxide, we get the product calcium carbonate again, means the product A is nothing but calcium carbonate. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option C, calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate is the correct answer, means A formed in the particular reaction is calcium carbonate. Next question number 84. The value of the spin only magnetic moment for one of the following configuration is 2.84 Bohr magneton. The correct one is, see the question once again. The value of the spin only magnetic moment for one of the following configuration is 2.84 Bohr magneton. The correct one is option A, D5U in presence of strong field ligand. Option B, D3 in weak as well as in strong fields. Option C, D4 in weak ligand fields. D, D4 in strong ligand fields. Yes, students, observe the points related to this question here. In presence of D5, strong ligand field, T2Z, here two pair of electrons and one unpaired electron, and AC orbital is empty, where mu equal to n into under root of n plus 2 is becomes equal to under root of 3. Value of Bohr magneton is nothing but 1.73. And in presence of D3, in weak as well as in strong field, T2Z contain 3 unpaired electrons and EZ is empty, where mu equal to under root of 3 into 5U, it is under root of 15, means 3.874 magneton. And D4, in weak field ligand, T2Z contain 3 unpaired electrons and EZ contain 1 unpaired electron, where mu equal to under root of 4 into 6, but under root of 24, means 4.894 magneton. And D4 in strong ligand field contain one paired electron and two unpaired electron in T2Z orbitals, and EZ orbital is empty, where mu equal to 2. The root of 2 into 4 is nothing but root of 8, means 2.824 magneton. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option D. Bohr magneton. Therefore, option D is the right answer. Next question number 85. N2 and O2 are converted into monoanions. N2 and O2 are converted into monoanions, N2 minus and O2 minus respectively. Which of the following statement is wrong? Option A, in N2 minus and N minus N bond, in N2 minus NN bond weakens. Option B, in O2 minus OO bond order increases. Option C, in O2 minus OO bond order decreases. Option D, N2 minus becomes paramagnetic. Yes, students, first you observe this column, species with bond order. N2, its bond order is 3, O2 molecule, its bond order is 2, N2 minus bond order is 2.5, O2 O2 minus its bond order is 1.5. Then the oxygen-oxygen bond in O2 minus decreases. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option B in O2 minus. Oxygen-oxygen bond order oxygen-oxygen bond order is decreases. Sorry, option C is the right answer. Because in O2 minus oxygen-oxygen bond is O2 minus decreases. Next question number 86. The structure and hybridization of SiCS3-4 is. The structure and hybridization of SiCS3-4 is. Option A, bent sp. Option B, trigonal sp2. Option C, octahedral sp3d. Option D, tetrahedral sp3. Yes. The structure of and hybridization of SiCS3-4 is, see here, hybridization in SiCS3-4 is calculated like this, of 4 plus 4 plus 0 minus 0 equal to 4 is sp3, which is tetrahedral structure. Therefore, option D is the right answer. Next question number 87. In a reaction, A plus B gives C plus D. The initial concentration of A and B were 0.9 mole per dm cube each. At equilibrium, the concentration of D was found to be 0.6 mole per dm cube. What is the value of equilibrium constant for the reaction? See the question once again. In a reaction, A plus B gives C plus D. The initial concentration of A and B were 0.9 mole per dm cube each. At equilibrium, the concentration of D was found to be 0.6 mole per dm cube. What is the value of equilibrium constant for the reaction? Option A is 8, option B is 4, option C is 9, option D is 3. Yes. For answer, students, see here. The reaction is A plus B gives C plus D. Here initial concentration 0.9 and B is 0.9. Let's see, and B is 0. At equilibrium, it becomes 0.3 of A and 0.3 of B. Then the product form 0.6 and 0.6 of D, where Kc equal to 0.6 into 0.6 divided by 0.3 into 0.3. Finally, we get the answer 4. Therefore, correct answer for this question is option B, that is 4. Next question number 88. Cesium chloride crystallizes in body-centered cubic lattice. Cesium chloride crystallizes in body-centered cubic lattice. If A is its edge length, then which of the following expression is correct? Option A, R cesium plus RCl minus is equal to 3A. Option B, R cesium plus plus RCl minus is equal to 3A upon 2. Option C, R Cs plus RCl equal to root of 3 divided by 2A. Option D, R cesium plus RCl minus equal to root of 3A. Students, see this diagram. Relation between radius of cation and anion and edge length of the cube is given as 2R cesium plus plus of 2R Cl minus is equal to under root of 3A. Then R cesium plus R Cl minus equal to under root of 3A upon 2. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option C. Option C is the right answer. cesium chloride crystallizes in body-centered cubic lattice. If A is its edge length, then the following expression is correct. Which one? R cesium plus plus of R Cl minus equal to under root of 3 by 2A. Next question number 89. An example for Perkinson reaction is option A, C6H5CHO means benzaldehyde is treated with CH3NH NO2. In presence of KOH, it gives C6H5CHCHNO2. Option B, C6H5CHO plus of CH3CO2O. In presence of sodium acetate, C6H5CH double bond CHCOOH is formed. Option C, C6H5CHO plus of CH3CHO. In presence of NaOH, it forms C6H5CH double bond CHCHO. Option D, C6H5CHO plus of CH2COOH2. In presence of alkaline NH3, C6H5CH double bond CHCO2H is formed. Yes, students, in general, see the reaction. Aromatic aldehyde in presence of cyanide ion, it forms acyl ions. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option B. We know the general reaction, aromatic aldehydes in presence of cyanides, acyl ions are formed. Carefully observe the options. When you observe the options carefully, then the correct answer for this question is option B. It is an example for Perkinson reaction. Next question number 90, means last question. The ether that undergoes electrophilic substitution reaction is. The ether that undergoes electrophilic substitution reaction is. Option A, CS3OC2H5. Option B, C6H5OCS3. Option C, CS3OCS3. Option D, C2H5OC2H5. Question, the ether that undergoes electrophilic substitution reaction is.
According to Doubtman, only alkene 1 area.
Carefully observe the given options. Yes, students, only aromatic ethers undergo electrophilic substitution reactions. Is it right? Only aromatic substitution reactions undergoes electrophilic substitution reaction. Therefore, if you know this concept, then the correct answer for this question is this one. Option B is the right answer. The ether that undergoes electrophilic substitution reaction is option B, C6H5OCS3. Okay, thank you, students. All the best for your NEET exam. Do well.